And Justice Department official says it is high time for government to weigh the pros and cons of the POGO industry. DOJ Undersecretary Raul Vasquez adds, even government agencies must review their processes in monitoring and granting licenses to POGOs.
Unfortunately, on the face of the documents as submitted by the applicants for license with POGO, they appear to be genuine. They appear to be proper. There were no red flags as of then. Everything now is in the open. So this is the reason why it is an opportunity for government to really take a long and serious look at its processes. The fact alone that he gave directive for dropping the anvil of the law, so to speak, against POGO and its illegal activities is best proof that the good Secretary Jesus Crispin Boyeng is against the adverse consequences of the POGO.
Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez says he is open to hearing issues concerning POGO hubs. Romualdez adds the House bills seeking to ban POGOs will also have to go through the legislative process. In February, a House panel approved a measure seeking a nationwide POGO ban and revoke existing licenses, but this has yet to be tackled at the plenary. Meanwhile, Surigao del Norte lawmaker Robert Ace Barbers is urging President Marcos to ban POGOs. Barbers says there's no redeeming value in POGOs, and banning them would rid the country of a culture of crime and gambling.
While House lawmakers are open to hearing issues linked to offshore gaming operators, Senator Aimee Marcos wants the gaming regulator to suspend the processing of new POGO applications. The senator also urged PAGCOR to review how it can better regulate this sector after POGOs have been found to be linked to illegal activities, including scam operations and human trafficking. Senator Marcos is opposed to a total ban of POGOs.
I think right now, kasi sinasabi nga, nakikinig naman ako sa PAGCOR at sa ating pamahalaan na kumikita ang Pilipinas dyan. Okay, pero hanggang hindi natin maisaayos, ang akin is suspende muna. Ayusin muna, hindi ako tutol. Katulad ng iba na totally i-scrap ang sugal. Ang akin, bahagi ng turismo kung mamamanage. Kaya nga lang, kung ganito kagulo at kung sino-sino na ang pumapasok, nakokorrupt na lahat ng opisyal at lahat ng ahensya ng gobyerno, itigil na muna yan.
Senator Marcos also recommends seeking the help of Chinese authorities to identify criminals and fugitives involved in POGO operations. Militant groups trooped to the U.S. Embassy in Manila as part of their commemoration of Independence Day. Our correspondent Jeff Caparaz is on the line for the details. Jeff?
Yes, Denise, various progressive groups converged along Rojas Boulevard, corner Calo Avenue in Manila this morning for their Independence Day protest. The group wanted to hold their program in front of the U.S. Embassy but were blocked by the personnel of the Manila Police District meters before the building. The groups condemned the military and the political intervention of the U.S. in the country. They say the plan of the U.S. to put up bases is a threat to security. Even if they were not able to get near the embassy, the group says the protest was a success, or it is a validation that there is a crisis in poverty and human rights violations which the government are trying to hide. Overall, the protests are peaceful and there are no untoward incidents reported.
Ongoing pa po ang International Labor Conference sa Geneva. Nandun ang kinatawan ng gobyerno sa pangunguna ng Department of Labor, nagkakalat ng kasinungalingan na ang buhay daw ng mga manggagawang Pilipino ay relatively maayos kumpara sa nakdaang administration. Pwes isa itong malaking kasinungalingan. Malinaw na lalong naghihirap ang mamamayang Pilipino sa halos 2 taon ni Bongbong Marcos. Walang bangon Pilipinas, walang bagong Pilipinas ang meron sa ilalim ni Bongbong Marcos ay bulok na Pilipinas. Hindi tayo ipagtatanggol ni Bongbong Marcos laban sa China. Ang relasyon po ni Bongbong Marcos ay mas malapit sa Estados Unidos. Ang US ay nanguupat, nanunulsol para gawing maluba ang tensyon sa pagitan ng China at ng Pilipinas at itulak tayo sa isang gyera.
Nakita natin naging mapayapa naman yung ating kilos protesta dito. At sapat yung ating hanay na nandito ngayon. At ganun din naman yung ating mga kababayan, yung mga progresibong grupo na nandito kanina. Nagpapasalamat din kami at naging payapa naman yung nangyari nilang pagpuprotesta dito sa ating lugar.
Denise, after the program, the groups got dispersed and the situation in the area came back to normal. Denise.
Thanks, Jeff.